In terms of moving on to the next one, I don't actually know anything about this, but there's a very technical term that's been inserted on this sheet called techno-chauvinism. So yeah, please talk us through this.
Yeah, so this is a very short one. I finished a book yesterday, I think it was yesterday, called Artificial Unintelligence, which I think is a great title to start off with. It's by a researcher by the name of Meredith Broussard. And to be honest, I was very disappointed with the book. I think it had a great premise to start off with and a great title, and I was very excited when I bought it. But when I read through it, I found the book quite weak, and that was disappointing. And so that's why I'm not recommending it to go and read it. All I wanted to pull out was this one term, this one idea. And this is just a reminder that even in bad books, there are key ideas you can pull and golden nuggets, nuggets you can pull from anywhere. So this is the golden nugget that I pulled from this book, and that's that term, like you said, techno-chauvinism. Basically, what this term tries to encapsulate is this idea from people who love technology, and the idea that this dogmatic approach that says technology is going to make everything better in every circumstance, right? So the idea is that a lot of us, and I think I'm often fall into this camp, is that I think the more technology, the better, and technology is going to make things better and better no matter what. And what Meredith Broussard tries to push back against is exactly this, and saying that, hold on, technology is very useful in certain instances and for certain types of things, but we must be careful not to be dogmatic about it and just assume that data and technology will always make things better. An example that she uses is that often we kind of think that data-driven insights are always better than human gut decisions, right? Because we can look at numbers on a spreadsheet and we can say, cool, we can see the data, we can see objectively what happened, and therefore we can make decisions based on that. What she kind of reminds us is that that data is all human-generated anyway, right? A human decided how to collect that data, or where to put the sensors, or how to structure that data, how to clean it, how to present that data. And with graphs and numbers, you can do whatever you want, right? You can do amazing things with it, and you can show 8 or 9 different scenarios from one piece of information. And so all this term is trying to remind us is that do not get caught up in this technology makes everything better all the time, because that's not the case. There are certain instances where we need to say no to technology and use our human instinct and judgment, for the moment at least, and just kind of be more careful with how we use the word data and not just think that data is perfect and data is clean and data is ready, because it's not. It's created by humans, and there are flaws and biases and prejudice and all sorts of things baked into those, into that data, and therefore into the algorithms themselves. And so that's all I've got to say on that one. I just wanted to raise that point. If you would like to go and read the book, please don't. Go and find a summary online. But techno-chauvinism is a great idea and a great term that I think we should be thinking about. And just keeps us on the straight and narrow. Technology is not always the best thing.
Absolutely. Yeah, I mean, thanks for grabbing that golden nugget and certainly highlighting that it's, you know, not such a great book in terms of the sort of key theme and in terms of how it met your expectations.
Yeah, so I just want to say, like, I think we need more books like this. So that's why I was so disappointed. I think there are books to be made on the other side of the coin, right? Yeah. So AI is a very, very topical discussion and something I'm very passionate about. I want to see more books pushing back on the concept of AI. And so this one wasn't executed well, but I'm hoping there are more books coming in the future which have a similar premise, but arguments are a bit stronger.
Amazing. Pond across the pond.